Hello, welcome to Dr. Boyson's Reality Check. In our previous chapter on occupational health and safety, we discussed the risk controls, and in topic 5, we'll be discussing hazard identification and reporting, and also we'll look at the health and safety policy. So what is hazard identification? We are saying that hazard identification takes persistence to characterize known hazards and creatively to identify the ways the system design or operation can lead to an accident or some incident happening. And hazard identification identified by employees should be reported to their immediate supervisors for required actions and controls to be put in place. But hazard identification is seen one as one of the most important part of safety analysis effort. So we could see that as a step towards defining the problem that has to be what resolved. Okay, and there are various methods for identifying hazards. And in identifying those hazards, there are some questions and some processes that we need to go through to ensure that employees and employers are able to identify the right hazards and that the mitigation measures are put in place to avert or prevent the hazard from causing a potential risk to the employees. So we say that you need to ask employees to carefully study and monitor their work and work processes as well as the environment. And then also a monthly hazard inspection should be conducted using a hazard inspection checklist where all the hazard, potential hazard that we think that could happen will be listed on those checklists as of when we see them. We could categorize them into various types of hazard, whether biological, whether safety hazard, whether physical hazard, whether chemical hazard, or whatever type that we see it to be. And we're saying that after that, we conduct safety checks and job safety analysis, observing a job from start to finish, and also recording the steps inherent in that. And if we do that, it gives us the opportunity to assess from end to end the process and identify specific hazard that probably previously may not have been identified. And also we need to conduct safety audits. It could be internal audits and that should be conducted by the safety department. It could also be external audit. And in most cases, when you have an external audit, the external auditors would then give you a report and then indicate the kind of recommendations that you need to implement. And these may be measures that they will recommend you put in place to forestall any hazard should they happen. So from hazard identification, then we proceed to reporting the hazard. So how do we report having identified a hazard? We're saying that reporting is a mechanism for all staff to inform management about safe conditions or equipment within the workplace. So not all hazard must be reported before action is taken. Some should be, some minor hazards should be, for instance, dealt with by employees when the hazard is very acute. And in situations where hazard are minor, as I'm saying, or within the control of a worker, he or she may take active steps to eliminate them and prevent them from happening. Hazards are reported to managers and supervisors responsible for the area of their work where the hazard has been identified. And this process is one of the single most effective means of injury prevention or accident prevention or the occurrence of accident. And by being proactive, workers being proactive and using workplace hazard report, there will be fewer hazards, accidents and injuries, and then less human sufferings, and then low cost also being seen. Okay, so proactivity is required from workers to ensure that very minor hazard can be prevented before they happen. And hazards in the workplace may be reported in a number of ways. maybe a verbal report to a supervisor, completing hazard report form is also another, and raising the issue also as debates or a staff meeting is also a way of reporting these hazards. And acute hazards should always be reported immediately to supervisors for immediate action to be carried out. And hazards that are less acute may simply require completion of a hazard report form and forwarding it to the appropriate person for action to be taken. So thank you for your time, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel on Dr. Poison's Reality Check, and then click on the notification bell so that we can send you more videos as and when we load on YouTube. We'll be dealing with health and safety policy in the next chapter. Thank you.